r/AskReddit, what is a fact about the human body that not many people know about? We have a fifth valve in our hearts that seals up right after we're born. Apparently anything similar to that afterwards is a huge surgical procedure. The human body is amazing. If you squirt warm water into someone's ear with a syringe, their eyes will automatically turn to the side that you squirted the water. If you use cold water, their eyes will automatically turn to the other side. https://n.wikipedia.org/wiki/caloric_reflex_test. Humans are one of a few species of mammal that oddly don't produce their own vitamin C due to lack of a certain enzyme. Other mammalian species who exhibit this mutation are those contained in the main primate suborder Haplorini, monkeys, apes, tarsiers, as well as bats, capybaras, and guinea pigs. All other mammals produce vitamin C in the liver. Your brain continues to try to revive the body long after the heart has stopped. In some cases 30 hours later there has been found brain activity trying to make repairs to bring the body back. This is used to indicate time of death in murder victims. Edit. Upon research I should clarify, the brain survives after the heart stops for several minutes. However, electroencephalomagnetic, e.g., brain activity continues for not only 30 hours but in some cases up to 72 hours after brain death. The link for the information is here, https://pubmed.inspi.nlm.nih.gov/361971/. Most reflexes never make it to your brain. The sensory aspect travels to the spinal cord and the spinal cord itself sends the muscle movement signals to your limbs. Apparently about 20% of people have a bony ridge on the roof of their mouth. Most people's palates are smooth with a very slight ridge. The 20% like me have an exaggerated and more pronounced ridge. Apparently it's most common in women and Asian folk, and I'm neither, so that's neat. I always thought it was totally normal. That the body's pH is 7.35 to 7.45, and if any of those scam products that promise to change the pH of your body actually worked, you'd be dead. People who live in extreme conditions for generations adapt in extreme ways. For example, people that live in high elevations often have larger lungs and different blood makeup. Or my favorite is the Beijiao people that live on the water and spend a lot of their time diving. Their spleens have become 50% larger in order to store more blood. https://n.wikipedia.org/wiki/sama. Beijiao #free diving_adaptations. Your brain likes stimulation. If it doesn't get any, it will make some up. Some people are more susceptible to it than others. The colors you see before you fall asleep are a common mild occurrence. There are several classes of these hallucinations. Closed eye visuals, which are caused by leaving your eyes closed for a long time. Hypnagogia, which is caused by the onset of sleep. Prisoner's cinema, which is caused by looking into a dark place for a long time. Ganzfeld effect, which is caused by blocking out all external stimuli. And Charles Bonnet syndrome, caused by sight loss. Most are these are simple phosphens, but some can be whole imagined scenes, or more abstract fractal, like imagery. 30% of body waste is excreted via skin. When you get conditioned to physical activity, your circulatory system adapts. More blood, more vessels, more blood cells, but your lungs really don't. This is because no matter how much blood your heart is able to deliver to your lungs, the lungs still have no problem oxygenating it. This is why your oxygen saturation doesn't drop during exercise, unless you have a heart defect. Edit. Thanks to the actual professional in the field, who I quote below, elite endurance athletes can push themselves hard enough to the point of creating noticeable oxygen desaturation during bouts of maximal intensity exercise. This is largely due to three factors, the first being the massive venous blood return, the second being large cardiac chamber filling, and the third being high heart rates during this maximal intensity. These elite athletes are able to pump such large volumes of blood per beat that the deoxygenated blood isn't spending enough time in the lungs to become saturated to a typical 96-98%. Babies can break their collarbone during delivery. It happens quite often, but heals quickly. My teacher told me that, if it happened to you OFC, you may feel a slightly higher spot on your collarbone, called the callus, where the fracture grew back together. There's a right and a wrong way to swallow, and the first swallow pattern you learn isn't the right one. Babies swallow by pushing their whole tongue forward, since it's better for nursing. However, as you transition to solid foods, you are supposed to change to a swallow where you put the tip of your tongue on the roof of your mouth and roll the food back. Not everyone does, and those that don't are more likely to choke, eat too fast, develop dental problems, and some develop a lisp or distorted sounds as they learn to talk. Edit. After seeing many of the comments and other professionals bringing up good ethical points, I feel the need to add some extra info and disclaimers. I did not intend to imply that anyone who feels they swallow wrong based on this information has to get an evaluation/therapy. I only wanted to share information I find fascinating and let those with concerns or fear know that you have the right to seek a professional if you so desire. If I did encourage you, or you felt I did, I only meant to encourage you to feel comfortable seeking out professional advice or assistance. Any techniques or screeners mentioned are only that, and cannot identify a disorder. Only an evaluation with an appropriate professional can do that, and that professional can vary with a variety of factors. If you do try to analyze your swallow, please don't actively try the incorrect swallow. It can potentially be unsafe to try any swallow you are not used to. Please be careful if you decide to disregard this warning. I did not intend to imply that just because you have any of the aforementioned characteristics that you have the wrong swallow. I did not intend to imply that this type of incorrect swallow is the cause of whatever difficulties, scary moments, etc., you experience. Thank you all for all the interesting stories, questions, comments, and feedback. I hope you enjoyed a little awareness about something most people never think about and found any correlations, but not necessarily causations, as interesting as I did. Positive blood type women can have positive and negative blood type babies without issue. Negative blood type women require a shot with antibodies to prevent the mother's immune system from attacking the fetus if it is a positive blood type. Human eggs are small but big enough to be visible to the human eye. One of the things that make humans unique from other animals is the fact that there is no actual bone in human boners. All other apes have them, although they are reduced in size and most other mammals do too. Notable exception being rats. Edit. Rats have M, rabbits don't. We don't know exactly why we are missing this bone called a baculum. The best theory I've seen is that without an actual bone, only relatively healthy male humans can copulate. 39% of people have an extra bone in their knee. 100 years ago only 11% of people had this bone. You can calm yourself down by splashing cold water on your face to trigger the mammalian diving reflex. Humans have, on average, just as many hairs on their body as chimpanzees. Human hair is just a lot shorter and finer. The shoulder blade is a more complicated joint than you'd think. While the hip is a ball and socket that just rotates, the shoulder can fold forward. If you sit with your back against the chair, hold your hand on your collarbone, then try moving your shoulder forward, you should be able to move the joint forward without moving your back from the chair. In theory, humans could breathe a liquid if it was super saturated with oxygen. It wouldn't be easy because the density of liquid being so much higher than air, so after 15 minutes or so you would be too fatigued to continue breathing. The hardest part is getting all the liquid out of the lungs so the person doesn't get pneumonia. The surface area of the lungs is about the same size as a tennis court. You can live normally with half your brain. In some severe drug-resistant epileptic syndrome in young kids, the only option to stop the seizures is to remove a complete brain hemisphere. After a while, with proper re-education and all, the children can go on to have a normal life without cognitive deficit. They will have a limping blindness from one eye and a very weak arm, but can lead a normal life and not end up cognitively impaired. One of the earliest signs of Alzheimer's disease, before the memory loss, could be the loss of the sense of smell. It's also the case with Parkinson's disease. Our brain looks wrinkled because it is actually folded inside our skull in order to fit a maximum of surface and thus neurons and cell communications. Some animals like rodents have a completely smooth brain. There are tiny cilia that spin in a certain direction. If they spin in the opposite direction while you're developing in the womb early on, that is how you get organs transposed onto the opposite side of your body. The hyoid bone is a bone not attached to any other bones in the human body and is only considered the anchor of the tongue. Swallowing has a cool down. Every minute you shed over 30 000 dead skin cells off your body. When you have a bowel movement, your heart rhythm shifts temporarily due to a vagus response. The reason Elvis died on the toilet was because his heart was beating 200 plus BPM and the quick rhythm change caused a myocardial infarction. People with low heart rates have been known to pass out on the toilet because their bodies can't handle the shift. It's also why EMTs will absolutely not let you use the bathroom before getting on the ambulance, especially if the bathroom is a standard 5x8. You can grow a new human being faster than most missing toenails can grow back. Some people have inner monologue, some don't. Our brains make up, on average, around 2% of our body weight but consume 20% of our caloric intake. Each one of your eyes has a blind spot where the optic nerve exits your eye into your brain. You can't see it because your brain tricks you not to see. It covers the spot with some made-up image of what it thinks fits better with the rest of it. You can test and, see it for yourself here. If you faint at the sight of your own blood, you may have an oversensitive vasovagal response. The theory is that this developed as a survival mechanism, kind of like an opossum playing dead. When doing surgery where the doctors have to take out some organs, when placing them back, they don't have to be put back in the exact position they're meant to be. Your body kind of just moves the organs into the correct position after the surgery. Synovial joint fluid is the most frictionless stuff on the planet, unless they've syntheticed something up that recently. It's superlube. The sensation of suffocating isn't caused by the thing that actually kills you. You'll die from a lack of oxygen. But the feeling of suffocation is the result of being unable to exhale carbon dioxide. So if you started breathing in pure nitrogen while being able to exhale normally, you would pass out and die without ever feeling like you were suffocating. This also explains why some languages call nitrogen something like suffocation gas. The human body typically only uses 30% of its muscle strength. The only times where your body will activate full power is when it's life or death. The cost of full muscle power is torn muscles, broken bone, stress, and in some cases, lacerations. The chance of a natural pregnancy with identical triplets is 1 in 200,000,000. Humans have stripes, we just normally can't see them. They're called Blaszczak lines and form along the paths of embryonic cell migration. The stripes are sort of U, shaped down our front, V, shaped on our back, wavy on the head and face, and we have basic, simple stripes on our extremities. Pregnant women have 50% extra blood. Migraine pain can lessen from vomiting. Vomiting can cause dehydration. Dehydration can cause migraines. The human body is funny. The eyeball is the fastest healing part on your body. Your stomach is surrounded by more brain cells, 500 million neurons, than the brain of a cat contains in total. It's your enteric nervous system. It controls digestion, operates autonomously, has its own memory, can handle its own reflexes. It has its own senses even. It's thought to have come about because of the blood-brain barrier and the main brain being locked away in the skull, a spinal column and nerves away from the critical action of nutrition. Your eyes have a separate immune system from the rest of your body, and in a lot of occasions if your body's immune system finds your eyes, they will assume they are a foreign body and blind you. It's possible to pull a jaw muscle while yawning. I found this out the hard way at work one day. When you cry and your nose becomes runny, it's actually your tears. The human genome is about 8% virus DNA. Over millions of years, various sequences of virus genes have gotten stuck in our DNA and copied faithfully ever since. Most of them are now non-functional, but at least a few of them seem to still work and actually code for useful proteins. This suggests that viruses might occasionally serve as a helpful source of mutation in the evolutionary process. That there is not 20 pounds of toxic poop in your body at any given time. Fuck those ads. But apparently a ton of people still believe all sorts of ads about some pill or another being able to flush some imaginary toxins out of your body like it's going to magically cure you of 20 years of terrible eating and exercise habits. Touch between your eyes, then push up with your tongue of roof of your mouth. You can barely feel a bone move. If you do this while your nose is stuffed, it will make it drain about a minute later. The average adult has 22 square feet of skin. Perfect size for a nice rug. Our bodies have the ability to perform their own bypass procedures. My grandfather went in for a scan and it showed a 100% blockage in one of his major arteries. The image also showed a new portion of the artery starting 0.25 before the blockage and then rejoining the artery 0.25 after the blockage, completely bypassing the obstructed portion. He had never had surgery before this discovery. You hate the sound of your recorded voice because it's missing the low frequency you're used to hearing. When you talk, you hear your voice as it goes to the air and back to your ear. It also goes through your skull to your ear, and this bone conduction mechanism transmits the low frequencies better than air does. Your recorded voice only has the air transmitted sound. That causes the dissonance between what you think your voice sounds like, and what it really does. It's also why your voice will, almost, always be higher pitched than you think. If you carry a lot of unprocessed trauma, it can cause psychosomatic autoimmune diseases. The appendix is not a vestigial organ, it actually protects good bacteria in the gut. You can live without it, but it's not just chillin' in there. Edited to add that this is relatively new research. Also, I'm not a doctor or anything, just an avid podcast listener who recently learned this on Stuff You Should Know. Apparently not everyone knows that women grow a new organ while pregnant. In addition to growing a child, they grow the placenta. Humans feel less satisfaction when they don't gain anything from an interaction. In other words, you get less dopamine, or whatever feel-good chemical, when you do something that basically has an equal cost and reward. This has led me to believe that free food does really taste better. It never made sense to me why cupcakes only tasted good when kids brought them in for their birthday. Whenever I'd buy them on my own, they tasted worse. I guess it's because my brain knows I spent money on them. It only takes about 15 pounds of force to rip off a human ear. Baby don't get kneecaps until 2-6 years old. Your body will reduce your muscle strength to protect your spine. Stand on flat ground, hold your arms out in a T pose, and have a friend push down on your hand while you try to hold it in place. That's your control, how strong you actually are. Now, remove one shoe, or put a book under one foot, and repeat with your hips askew so your spine isn't straight. An inch is all it takes. Your strength will be reduced to the point that your friend can use a single finger to push your hand down. We all have a major artery called the ascending aortic artery that runs down the center of our abdomen. Another artery, called the superior mesenteric artery, branches off of that. There is a gap between the arteries that is kept open by a pad of fat, and the start of our intestines, called the duodenum, passes right through the gap between the two arteries. Very, very rarely something can happen to shrink the fat pad, and then the arteries act like a clamp and pinch the duodenum closed. This prevents anything, solid or liquid, from passing from the stomach into the intestines. This is called superior mesenteric artery syndrome. And I had it. It is so rare that it took 2 months of doctors excluding everything else for them to diagnose me. I couldn't keep anything down, and went from 120 to 90 pounds. I had to have where my intestines were connected to my stomach moved to another spot, and have about 6 feet removed in the process. This was almost 7 years ago now. Other than having to eat more than I used to in order to maintain my weight, I'm okay. That is only one of the weird, and very rare, medical conditions that I'm living with, but you'd never know by looking at me. A human body can be drained of blood in 8.6 seconds, given adequate vacuuming systems. You can remember how many muscles there are in a human arm with the number 420. Usually there are 4 muscles in the upper arm and 20 in the lower arm, but some people have only 19 muscles and are missing the palmaris longus. You can see if you have it by bringing your fingertips together. If you have it, you'll clearly see a small tendon in your inner wrist right below your palm. You can poop out of your mouth if your intestines get backed up enough. It's like vomit. Doesn't look like actual poop per se, but it's still fucking disgusting. X-rays of children's mouths are nightmare fuel. The second set of teeth to replace baby teeth are already grown and lodged in their skulls. So you'll see 2 rows of teeth and it's freaky looking. They don't grow in when the old ones fall out. They are already loaded in the chamber waiting to get launched. You will sooner die from lack of sleep than lack of food. You can live, depending on your current body fat and health level, 4 months without food. Estimates are that you will die for lack of sleep within 2 weeks. Your brain regulates how strong your muscles are. If your leg muscles were to contract at full strength, they would snap your femur. It's why people in emergencies on adrenaline can lift cars off children. Your body is capable of great strength, but it could also severely damage you, so your brain keeps you awake. Soft bag of jelly. A rush of adrenaline will clear your sinuses. Oh man, I love shit like this. 1. The proportion of your vision that is actually in sharp focus roughly equates to the size of your thumbnail at arm's length. The rest of it is just your visual cortex filling in the blanks. 2. Scars are not made of permanent tissue. They're held together by collagen, and are in a constant state of repair. This repair is facilitated by vitamin C, amongst other things. Yes, this means that people with scurvy, from vitamin C deficiency, will see all their old scars reopen into fresh wounds. 3. Pineapple contains bromelain, an enzyme that ingests proteins. Your meat parts are mostly made of proteins, so when you're eating pineapple, it's also eating you. Humans are bioluminescent and glow in the dark, but the light that we emit is 1,000 times weaker than our human eyes are able to pick up. Source: mitochondria, the powerhouses of our cells according to every high school bio teacher, are just bacteria that permanently set up shop in our cells millions and millions of years ago. The heart can generate its own electrical impulses, i.e., action potentials, because it is constantly depolarizing. That's why a heart will continue beating even after it's removed from the body. When you have a vasectomy, you actually blow sperm in your balls and your body absorbs it. You basically cream pie yourself. It is possible to skewer a person from crotch to crown with a wooden pole without immediately killing them. In fact, with proper care and experience, it is possible to do it so that they live for a day or two. There is a bone in your right arm that can show how much you have left to grow. The average human erection has roughly about 130 ml of blood in it, while the average rabbit has about 126 ml in its entire body, so, there is more blood in a boner than in a bunny. Some women can feel the exact moment an egg is released from the ovary during ovulation. Feels like a little pop just on one side. Pretty neat. Fetuses have a tail and lose it by the time they're born. The heart smells like mushrooms. Source: I'm a cardiac anesthesiologist. Thanks for watching. Comment suggestions for any future videos and make sure to subscribe to not miss out on any more good content. I upload daily videos from r/askreddit, and if you liked the video, make sure to like the video.